Minasan, Okari Nasai. Today, I've got a God tier Seiyu. And that's it for the intro, because this video will already be long enough. Sora Amamiya, born August 28, 1993, in Tokyo. Affiliated with the agency Music Rain. While a sophomore in high school, she was introduced to a collection of roles from the voice actress Miyuki Sawashiro, who you may know as Sinan from Sword Art Online or Karapika from Hunter x Hunter. This was apparently all the motivation she needed to become a seiyu. Since her resume is so big, I will not be going over every role or even every lead role. So if I miss one of your favorites, feel free to mention it down below. Though I feel I covered all the iconic or the influential ones. So, let's begin. After passing an audition held by Music Rain in 2011, she made her voice acting debut in 2012, where she would voice Misuzu in the show From the New World. This was a supporting role, but not long after she had three roles in Aikatsu: Konatsu Hayase, Wakaba Kuze, and Yuna Nakayama. 2013, she technically had her first main role as Miyako Dokutsugi in a 2-minute promotional video for the manga 420 Renpai Girl. Then a bunch of supporting roles: Aika Hayase in the wrestling show Wannabe the Strongest in the World, Rona in Majestic Prince, and Liliana in Log Horizon. 2014 was her big year though, and I do mean big. First, she began her role of Honoka Mitsui in The Irregular at Magic High School, then a bunch of leads, starting with Kaori Fujimiya in One Week Friends, also singing the ending theme. Definitely gonna mispronounce this one, but Asylum vs. Elusa in Aldnoa Zero, Shiho Kitazawa in the Idolmaster movie Beyond the Brilliant Future, Toka Kirishima in Tokyo Ghoul, Elizabeth Leonis and Liz in The Seven Deadly Sins. She also had two singles released, Skyreach, the opening for Akame ga Kill, and Tsuki Akari, the second ending for the same show. That same show having her third big role, Akame, the main character. 2015, another good role, Isla in Plastic Memories, grab your tissues for that one, Miketan Narugino in Punchline, Natsuki Nito in Anthem of the Heart, Yamato Koki in Ninja Slayer from Animation, and Mia in Monster Musume. But this year, she was also a founding member of the pop group Trisail, and they released two singles throughout the year. Youthful Dream, the opening for Ultimate Otaku Teacher, where she would also voice Minako Kanao, and Cobalt, the opening for Classroom Crisis. I guess I should mention Trisail technically was formed in 2014, but they didn't fully debut until 2015. But she also had a solo song release as well, Velvet Rays, the opening for a game called Valiant Knights, along with her first photo book titled Soriro. Maybe it's Soriro, but there's no hyphen, so it looks like one word, and that word looks like Soriro. Finally for this year, she received the Best Rookie Actress Award at the 9th Seiyu Awards. 2016, Yukari in Divine Gate, Elise in Bungo Stray Dogs, Sophie in Izetta the Last Witch. Weirdly enough, those are all single-named characters. But we also got Shiho Kamakura in the show Working. And the big one, maybe her most iconic role within her resume of iconic roles, Aqua, the useless goddess in Konosuba. Trisail's first album, Sail Canvas, and two new singles were released. Those singles being Wiz, the ending theme of Koyomi Monogatari, nice, really good for them, and High Free Spirits, the opening for High School Fleet. In this series, she also voiced Moi Kachina. She then had her first album as a solo artist, Various Blue. Now we're on to 2017, Musubu Takatsuki in Handshakers, Shi Miao in the Chinese short series Please Take My Brother Away. Are we sure this isn't a Japanese show? That really sounds like a Japanese title to me. Also, what the hell was that name? It took me so many takes to do that without laughing. Rui Kanoya in Recreators, another really good show I highly recommend. But for this show, if you are unaware, it is about manga and anime creations coming to life, meaning the character Sora voices comes to the real world and, well, Sora, who naturally voices herself in the show, is hosting an event about the character. Can you imagine being a seiyu and voicing yourself in an anime? That's like peak. The last notable role of this year is Haruka Narumi in Battle Girl High School. Trisail's second album, Tailwind, and two more new singles were released. Original, the opening for Interviews with Monster Girls, a really fun, cute show, where she voiced Kurtz. Then Adrenaline, the ending theme for Ero Manga Sensei. I feel like this is their most popular song, since they perform it literally every year at Anisama. As a solo artist, she released two new songs, Irodori and Eternal. 2018, we have the very mid-show Killing Bites with her role of Hitomi Uzaki, but then two banger shows, Kozue Matsumoto in Baki, and Uzuki Hirokawa in Rascal Does Not Dream of Bunny Girl Senpai, which sounds like a really dumb name, I know, but let me tell you, it is an amazing show. Oh, and she was Doncho Arthur in Million Arthur, and Krush Lulu in Overlord Season 2. Three new Trisail songs this time: Wanted Girl, the opening for Time Boken, Truth, the second opening for Beatless, where she also voiced Methode, and Azure, the ending theme for the movie Zoku Owari Monogatari. As for her solo stuff, her second solo album, The Only Blue. I'll tell you the answer to this later, but for now, take a wild guess at what her favorite color is. She had her sixth single, Chikai, which was the ending theme of the second season of The Seven Deadly Sins. And finally, her photo book, 10 Looks, came out. 2019 is starting off strong with a Kemi Soryun in How Heavy Are the Dumbbells You Lift? A really good, cute girls working out educational show. Like, actually educational, by the way. It really does show you how to work out properly. But we also got Iana in Kamono Michi Rise Up, and the role of Illustrious in Azure Lane. And even a character named Candy in episode 572 of Doraemon. Then we've got Trisil's third album, Try Again. And Sora herself had three singles come out. Defiance, Viper, and Regeneration. That last one being the first ending theme of season 3 of The Seven Deadly Sins. Finally, another photo book titled High Tension. 2022 was another solid year despite how shitty the year really was. Ayame Himero in Science fell in love, so I tried to prove it. That is not grammatically correct, but that is what the show is called. And she sang the opening theme, Paradox, her only single of the year. Also, my personal favorite song of hers, along with Skyreach. She also voiced the young version of Keith Kloss in My Next Life as a Villainess. We got another crazy name here, Alice Lise Lou Nebulis, the 9th, in Our Last Crusade. IX is 9, right? In Roman, let me look this up real quick. Yeah, it's 9. She's the 9th Alice Lise Lou Nebulis. Who the hell names a character that? Alright, moving on. Karura Hyogi in Yuna and the Haunted Springs. And Jean Xiaolong in The Race Around the World show, Apare Ranman. Honestly a good show, but when Steel Ball Run comes out, that show will be irrelevant. We've also got top tier waifu Chizuru Mizuhara in Rent-A-Girlfriend. Also top tier waifu Rurina, aka Nessa, in Pokemon Twilight Wings. Two Trisail songs, Free Turn, which was the opening for the High School Fleet movie, and a double single, Gomakashi, the opening for Magia Record, and Utsurori, which is featured in the Magia Record game and technically came out in 2019, but only purchasable in 2020. She also voiced the character Yachiyo Nanami. As for a solo artist, she had her third album, Paint It Blue. Ah, I see what they did there. Good reference. Have you figured out what her favorite color is yet? The last thing for this year is that she started to make her own little comic on Twitter. Since she was stuck at home like the rest of us, this lasted for about 2 months until she started being able to go back to work in person. 2021, we're almost done. Kind of. Not really, though. Elna Stongs in The Hidden Dungeon Only I Can Enter. Yarandrala in Banished from the Hero's Party. Miku Yotsuyain in Meriku-chan. And Ruri Tendo in Idly Pride. Later joining the live-action version of Trisail. Trinity Ale. Trisail? Hold on. Sora? Sheena? Momo? Well, would you look at that? Joking aside, the Idly Pride group is called Trinity Ale. Trisail's fourth album, Reborn Voyage, and a new song as well, Dariga Tame Niaiwa Naru, the opening for SD Gundam World Heroes. She then released something really cool, an album called Covers, Sora Amamiya's Favorite Songs, which is her covering her favorite songs. This is my first time ever hearing of a seiyuu doing this. I need more of it, honestly, it's a really good idea. Three new singles as well. Ayan no Aria, the opening for season 4 of The Seven Deadly Sins. Three Sia, the ending for a Chinese animated show, Heaven's Official Blessing. And Meine Karune. This and its coupling song were the opening and ending of Meriko-chan, a show I am now very interested in after hearing her talk about it so much. 2022, Erika Kizaki in Akebi's Sailor Uniform. Miyako Izumo in season 2 of Princess Connect Redive. Sena Narumi in Heroines Run the Show. Fuko in a 30th Crayon Shin-chan movie. 30 movies, holy shit. And Nazuna Nanakusa in Call of the Night, which is currently airing. Sora is also taking great pride in making all the weird sucking noises her character makes. Right at the beginning of this year, however, she released two best of albums. First one was Red, and the other, you already know, it was Blue. Keeping with this, she had her best live tour, and Trisail has released two new songs. Lapis, the ending for a new Magia record season, and Hana Renai Kiori, the opening for Aha Ren-san, Wahaka Renai. Also her newest 13th single, Love Evidence, the opening for the new season of Science Fell in Love. She even has a role lined up for next year already, Lily in Spy Classroom. Really looking forward to this. She has around 40 video game credits, mostly old mobile games like Dragalia Lost, Fate Grand Order, Granblue Fantasy, as always. Also all of her anime roles from Idolmaster, Irregular at Magic High, Seven Deadly Sins, Princess Connect, Battle Girl High, Tokyo Ghoul, Plastic Memories, Magia Record, Konosuba, Azure Lane, and Pokemon Masters EX. I've never said that many words in one breath before. But she reprised all those roles. Didn't even know there were games for half of those. Aside from all that, she's in Dragon's Dogma Online, Girls' Frontline, Digimon World Next Order, World of Final Fantasy, Shin Megami Tensei Liberation D2, Fire Emblem Heroes, Dragon Quest XI: Echoes of an Elusive Age, Star Ocean Anamnesis, Persona 5 Royale, The King of Fighters All-Star, Rune Factory 5, and Assassin's Creed Origins. She has even had voiceover roles in the live-action versions of anime series that she's been a part of, like One Week Friends and Rent-A-Girlfriend. Yeah, there's live-action versions of both of those. She was also in Kamen Rider Build as the character Vernage. Maybe it's Vernage, but Japan never uses the G as a J sound, so I'm thinking it's Vernage. As for foreign dubbing, she has 6 credits, with the most notable ones being in the School of Rock TV show and the Uncharted movie. Naturally, she has done many concerts with Trisail and Idolmaster, but she has also appeared at Annie Max Music's and Annie Mellow Summer Festival many times with both of those groups. Trisail has been at Annie Sama every year since at least 2016, and on top of that, she's appeared at those events as solo performers as well. Shoutouts to Annie Sama 2021 Day 3, where she had a duet with Maya Uchida, singing Kimi no Se. I'm going to give you the tiniest of fun facts and then make a separate video in the future with like 50 fun facts, okay? So here we go. She is 160 centimeters or 5'2". Her hobbies are karaoke and having fun alone. I totally feel that latter one. She is like terrified of bugs. And roller coasters. Actually, Sora just can't handle amusement park rides in general. But her English is very, very good. She is a big cat person, and while Sora was living with her grandparents, she had a cat named Himiko. She used to want to be reborn as a cat, and she prefers cats over dogs because, in her words, dogs are just a little too clingy. She has also said she wants to be married by her late 20s or early 30s, and she currently is in her late 20s. It is actually her 29th birthday on the day I am posting this video. After she gets married, she wants an all blue house with blue interior and exterior. By the way, if you haven't already guessed it, blue is indeed her favorite color, with black being her second favorite. She has her own YouTube channel, and I swear this woman never takes any photos of herself. Like, every single picture I found was her posing for someone else. And finally, her nickname is Ten-chan, because Sora can also be read as Ten. And with that, we have reached the ending. My voice will be absolutely destroyed tomorrow. But I hope you've enjoyed, and, well, I really hope you've learned something new about her. Please join me in the next one, where I'll be talking about... I don't even know yet, but I hope to see you there.
I'm Sora Amamiya. Thank you for always watching my videos! And my channel reached 150,000 subscribers! Thank you! I was surprised at lots of foreign languages in the comment section. I'm not good at speaking English, but I can read it a bit.